Motherfucker, where is it? Hi guys, welcome back to the vlog. I have something that I need. Maybe you just saw it.
Look at your face.
Maybe you just saw it.
Turn your head this way.
I saw, okay guys, so last night I really didn't want to self tan, but I have a lot of stuff to do, like filming and like TikToks and like Instagram things. And to be quite frank with you, when I'm not self tanned, I'm a literal piece of shit because I just feel like I don't know. I'm addicted to self tanner. Like, I understand that it's an addiction and I am addicted and I need to seek professional help. But anyway, so last night I was like, I really don't want to self tan, but I have to because I know if I don't, I won't get anything done tomorrow, meaning today. Well, I was really tired, but I was like, you know what? Let's just fucking do it. I did it. I got in bed. You know, I have like I have this like sheet that I lay on so I don't get it all over our bed. And usually after like an hour or so, I will put a shirt on, a long sleeve shirt, so that I don't get it all over myself because I like to hug myself while I'm sleeping. Well, I fell asleep because I was so tired and I forgot to put the shirt on and...
Sometimes Blake also gives me a present of that as well.
Guys. I do solemnly swear to tell the whole truth.
The whole truth.
So now...
Yeah, we're getting fucking married. You better clean that shit up.
Oh my god. I'm literally getting married in 2 days.
Better slough that stuff off.
All right, so let's see. We're gonna go to the World Wide Web and we're gonna see what can help the situation and I will report back on which things worked and which things did not work. So see you guys soon.
Okay.
John is like head cleaner in this house, so he's gonna know. Also, there's one thing that people told me to do, but people said not to do it also. Like, people were like, people are gonna say to use a magic eraser, but don't do it because it like can leave like shards of glass in your hand.
It's not glass though.
But I think I'm gonna try it if this one doesn't work.
Yeah. Okay. So we have Comet, we have Dawn, and we have a paddle callus remover.
Yeah.
Well, show them what happened though.
Well, I did.
Well, that's what happened.
I showed them before. Oh, okay. They've seen it.
Okay.
So also, there's other parts of my body that look not great, but this is quite truly the worst. So, like, I have a little bit on my face, and I have a little bit on my leg. That's fucked up, but whatever.
They're wet?
Yeah, they're wet. This is bleach.
All right, scrub them together. There you go. With a little water, though.
Oh.
It's like a, it's gonna smush it away.
Okay, the comment's in the way.
Oh.
Yeah, people also did say to do lemon as well.
Now start paddling. With the soft side. Just start paddling.
With the water?
Just go to town.
Okay.
I think I would do no water for now.
Okay.
Oh, look at that.
Okay, get a close up. Okay, we are seeing an improvement. Like right there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's getting good. We might not have to use the glass Mr. Clean.
It's just like a solvent that makes it slipperier. Keep going.
And it's funny because yesterday I told John when I was falling asleep, I was like, when I took a bath to take off my self-tanner, I usually use this like mitt and it doesn't work that well, but it works enough to like get the job done, to like take off my old self tanner to get my skin prepped for new self tanner. And okay, let's see. And this was sitting there and I was like, let me just try this little like scraper instead of the mitt. And it worked so well. It like took off my self tanner like so easily. Like I didn't have to like sit there and scrub. And it also made my legs feel really, really soft because I feel like this is like a really good exfoliant. So yeah. Where'd you get this? On Amazon?
Yeah.
I think we need to buy a few more. This is about 1 minute after scrubbing.
That's great.
Yeah. Wait, it looks so good. I haven't done this one yet, but.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, it doesn't look great, but like we're on our way. We're on our way to redemption.
Do I think this is the healthiest thing for you?
No, it's bleach.
No, it's fucking bleach, but who cares?
I mean, if you have...
You gotta do what you gotta do.
You have to. I was about to rub glass on my skin if I needed to.
You gotta do what you gotta do. Not saying to use this often, but...
Yeah.
Whatever.
Yeah, because the thumb definitely needs some work, but if I hid the thumb, look at the rest. Wow. I have, like, my hair on my leg grows back really quickly. Like, I can get out of the shower, and my leg hair will be grown back within, like, a few hours. Like, it'll be prickly. And when I did this thing and tried to take off my self-tanner, so I shaved my legs on Sunday, and then I would say that my hair just started to be prickly yesterday, which was Tuesday, which is so crazy because, like, that... Like, my hair literally gets prickly. I mean, my legs literally get prickly probably around 6 hours after I get out of the shower. So for them to last like a full 2 days without getting prickly is really... I really want to get laser hair removal on my legs. But again, you can't do that if you self-tan. And I self-tan year-round, which I'm going to maybe try to not do it. But I think you have to go like... for like 8 months in a row, and then like 8 months would be August, and...
Why can't you still tan?
Because something about like the laser hitting the color, and it can burn your skin, and...
Well, you just go once a month, so you're 6 months.
Yeah, but even like... Yeah, I don't know. Yeah.
I feel like it's doable. You're not going that often. I feel like it's every 6 weeks or something.
I think, yeah, I don't know. I have to look into it. If any of you guys have had laser hair removal, I mean, everyone raves about it. But if anyone's had laser hair removal, sound off in the comments, because I know it is expensive, but like it's honestly worth it. I think in my, cause like I get like strawberry legs when I shave my legs. And like it hurts sometimes if I shave my legs like multiple times per week, which I don't typically do. But like if I have like events and stuff and things that I have to like, I don't know, wear dresses for, then... Tell me that I don't eat this every day. Tell me I don't eat this every day.
You don't.
Babe, you're kidding.
You don't eat that every
day. Babe, you know I do.
No, you eat it like 5 times out of the 7 days.
Oh my, okay, so sorry. 5 times out of the 7 days. I eat a piece of toast with kind of like a half of an avocado, 2 eggs, everything but the bagel seasoning. And usually the ketchup doesn't look as tragic as this, but we're at the bottom of our ketchup, so.
Yes.
I still feel okay, guys, so I am currently listening to
Even though I had
What We Said podcast. I love their podcast. It's like one of the only ones that I listen to. I just did my skincare. I did a face mask, which is the Image Skincare Ageless Total Resurfacing Mask. I love this one because it just feels like you're like getting a new layer of skin, especially because I'm wearing a lot of makeup today. Well, not right now, but I'm about to put on a lot of makeup just because I have to film and stuff. If you guys want me to do a skincare routine like morning and night for one of these like Vlogmas videos, let me know because I can do that. And then now I am Dysoning my hair. That's another thing. If you want a Dyson tutorial, let me know. I haven't done this side yet. I did a little bit of the back so far. I just worked up a sweat trying to get this camera on a tripod. I fucking hate this tripod. John loves it. I don't even know which one it is, but I like one where you can like snap the legs and then like bring it up and down. He likes one where you like twist it and I'm like, I can't fucking figure it out, and he's gone right now. So anyways, I just worked up a sweat doing that, but I'm gonna just do my Dyson, then put my makeup on, and then start filming. I just had a call with Michelle. I talked to her for a little bit, and yeah, everything's good with that. So yeah, I'm gonna continue to do the Dyson, and then we're gonna put some makeup on. I called because I wasn't able to use my hands because of this, but I have to shut this off anyway to talk.
Okay, love you.
Okay, love you. See you tomorrow.
Bye.
Bye. You might be thinking, that right side doesn't look like the left side. Well, it does when I brush it out. Like this is like cooled and like kind of brushed out and it's kind of fallen. I might go through maybe one or two more pieces and just curl them a little bit more, but I like just like the lived in blowout look instead of, like this is more like nighttime, you know? Like this is, I'm going to an event, like I'm going to dinner. This is more like, hey, I'm just like hanging out, like I'm just going for the day. So this will fall to this. If you don't want it to fall, just like heat blast or cool blast it. If you have the Dyson, it like has a cool setting. But yeah, so I'm just gonna let these like chill while I do my makeup. My friend Nicole just texted me and she was like, fancy wedding invites, which means she just got them. And she lives in LA, so I assume, we set them yesterday or the day before, but I assume that all of the rest of the people should be getting them probably within like 4 or 5 days. I feel like the holidays are a little bit longer in like the mailing time because there's just so much mail and so many packages and stuff. All right, let's do our makeup. Delaney was over my house. Well, it was before she went to New York, but she was over my house maybe like a month and a half ago, and I saw her rubbing this foundation in. It's the YSL new foundation, or like I guess skin tint, and I saw her rubbing it in with her hands, and ever since then I have been rubbing it in with my hands and then going over it with a beauty blender, and I swear it goes on so much better. I love it. Okay, that is the finished makeup look. So cute. Let me know if you want a full video on it because it took me like under 10 minutes. John got his Black Friday package. He only got two things. He got one shirt from Abercrombie and then he placed an order from Urban. So he's gonna do a little haul.
I think I got more stuff from Abercrombie.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought, oh.
Got these.
Oh, cargos. Those are cool.
Cargos from Urban.
Wait, show them, like, oh, actually I'll show them and you can. These are cool because
they're workwear, and so they have this double duck thing that's kind of popular right now, and I need black pants.
And Urban sale, like I didn't shop it because I was just like too busy to even like think about it, but Urban sale was sick, right?
Yeah, some things are like $7. So like, I think these were like $10.
Yeah.
But these are shorter, Dickies.
I'm sure they're gonna have like another sale for like around Christmas. So if they do, I'll let you guys know because I will definitely be shopping it.
You got a beanie?
John is in his beanie era. There's literally two, oh, you put them away. There's two beanies sitting over there a second ago.
I got green Dickies.
I want them. Wait, they're so cute. Wait, can you put these on?
Yeah, put them on.
Show
and
them.
And then I got, oh, these are corduroy, blue-black-ish.
Wait, those are so cool too. They're like, wait, those are really cool. They're like this corduroy, blue-black. It's probably not picking
it's
up the blue.
To be, yeah, it's supposed it's to like be black, dark, but dark, it's like really dark.
Dark blue. Blue. Wait, I want, can you try some on? Because I kind of want to see them. Like those are cute. I like those a lot.
Yeah, these are good. And they fit around the.
It's hard to tell the material on here, but it's like this corduroy. Oh, that's kind of better. Those are cool. Okay, next. By the way, I just listened to the What We Said podcast and it was their wish list episode, which if you haven't listened and you are like, what should I get for people or what should I ask for from people? Definitely give that a listen because they have some really good ideas on there. And it actually, my mom always asks, what do you want for Christmas? What do you want for your birthday? And I'm always like, nothing. I don't need anything. Like just, I don't need anything. But of course she always wants to give something. And so they had an idea of a flower subscription service. And you can like sign up for a year. You can do like every other week or once a month, once every other month. And I feel like that's a really cool thing for someone to give you or to give. I mean, it could be cool too, but for someone to give you, because then like throughout the year, you can like send them a picture of the flowers and be like, look what just got delivered. And it's kind of just like the gift that keeps on giving. Granted, I don't know pricing or anything. I literally just listened to it 1 second ago, but I'm gonna like look into it. And if it's not like way too expensive or anything, then I'm gonna send it to my mom. But I feel like it's definitely customizable because you can do, it just depends on how many times a year you want them delivered. But I'm gonna see how much it is to do either like 18, oh no. So I'm gonna see how much it is to do 12, like once a month or twice a month. Okay, cute, wait. Yeah, I like the Converse with it. It looks like a little bit edgy and stuff. Cute. You guys, the picture is not, it's not coming up with the color, but that's like, I love that color. Cute. Okay. You have one more pair. Myself wear these ones. I love these ones. I love like the.
This is the same fit as, this is the same fit as these. Though. The slightly longer fit.
They're not the same pant though, is it? Is it the same
pretty
exact?
Pretty much, it's just quarter and a different front pocket.
Yeah, wait, I love those. Okay, cool. And wait, I love, cool. Okay guys, I'm gonna go film some videos and then maybe I'll show you my lunch. I don't know if I'm gonna eat lunch though because it's already like 1:30 and I'm not hungry because my Adderall. Okay, so like a week or so ago, I asked you guys if you wanted our matcha recipe and so many of you said yes. So we're gonna make it today. It's so easy. Sometimes we add a little extra something in here and there, but like this is like the base matcha that we, this is like the base matcha latte that we make. Sometimes I add like a little bit of creamer or something if I'm like wanting something a little bit different, but like as the base, this is gonna get you by and I promise, well I can't promise that you're gonna like it, but I love it. And I used to not like matcha as much, but I feel like I wasn't using like good matcha. This is the one that we use now. It is the, it's the Peak Sun Goddess Matcha. You can get it on Amazon, but yeah, it's really good and they come in these like little packets. So you can take them on the go if you want to, but all right, we're gonna make them. Also, I feel like I'm such like a basic bitch, but I feel like ever since I started using these like round sphere ice cubes, I have been liking my drinks more. And we just got these on Amazon. They're a little bit melted because I've been doing stuff and I took them out a little bit ago, so my bad. But yeah, if you want to like up your drink game, definitely get like shaped ice cubes, because I promise
you can get squares, circles, flowers,
you can get like
skull and crossbones,
yeah,
like, whatever you want. It's just on Amazon.
Yeah, they're so cute and they're like so easy, they're like so easy to make too. So yeah, we heat it. Tell them what you did.
So you just heat like a quarter cup of water for about 30 seconds until it's nice and hot.
Okay.
And then we're gonna put the Peak. And these are nice because I don't have to measure it out. It's already measured. So if you want to do two things, two, one, one. Put it in. And then you're going to
whisk it up.
You do have to have a whisker. You can do a frother, one of those electric frothers. But the whisker is nice. So if I'm in a rush, I'll do the frother. But the whisker does it a lot better.
Mm-hmm. And you do it in Z motions, right?
Just, yeah, it's just like lines. Basically, it's a Z's.
And when do you know when you're done?
when it's nice and frothy. Okay. I'd say go for 15 seconds, look at it, go for another 15 seconds, but it really shouldn't take more than 30 seconds. Like, it's about to be done. So, everyday occurrence first, new glasses.
Love these glasses. You can get them on Amazon now.
Take your balls, throw them in. Okay, and then Blake puts
you can use any milk, but I use oat milk.
And how much do you like? Blake likes a milky drink.
I like to do it until like the second ball.
Nice. Get your balls in.
Yeah.
And then she likes a little bit of cinnamon. Ceylon cinnamon's like the healthy one. So a little bit, just a couple.
Mm-hmm.
And then like a tiny bit of honey.
Yeah, I would say like a
spoon. Just a little like a
like teaspoon. More than a teaspoon, less than a tablespoon, I would say. Yeah.
And then just mix that around. Because it's hot water, so it'll melt it all.
Mm-hmm.
And then you'll have this, and then you'll have this, and then you pour this into this. It makes a nice little color too.
Yeah.
See, the hardest part is pouring it without it getting all over the table.
And like, look at that.
But it does end up looking good.
Like.
And then she likes.
Look at that.
And the cherry on the cake for Blake is a flower straw.
Yep, I love a good flower straw. Those are also from Amazon. I will link them.
Ta-da.
The moment of truth. Stop it, babe. I like to mix mine around a lot because the water was like boiling and I like pretty cold drinks. So I like to mix it around a lot so that it gets colder. I just mix it for like 30 seconds.
To go.
It's good.
And you can add whatever creamers to it too. Like she has flavored ones that she
Sometimes. Sometimes if like we didn't use enough milk or we didn't use enough water, it can be a little bit strong. We got aura rings. If you guys have been watching the Vlogmas, you guys should probably know that we got aura rings for Black Friday because we've been wanting them for a long time. And they send, because we didn't know what size we were, so they send a little kit.
Well, you can either pick your size if you're really confident or you try it on your friend's aura ring.
But like, why would you do
that? They're different sizes than normal rings. So they send you this free cool kit and it's like super, that's like a great, because I have a friend, I actually have a friend that owns a ring company.
Yeah.
Like custom rings. And he said it's a 30% return because of fittings on rings. That's huge. So this is great.
So yeah, they sent this and I was like, oh, I'm probably a 7. So I like grabbed the 7. And you have to wear it on your pointer finger because of something.
They said the blood flow is the best on your pointer and then the next best would be your middle, but you want it to fit snug but not too snug,
right?
And your finger changes throughout the day, so you want to like wear it for a little bit.
So the 7 is like fine, but it's like hard to get off, so like I don't want it like that because, you know, sometimes my fingers swell and stuff. So if I had to have guessed, I was gonna wear the 7, but I'm glad that I didn't because this is the 8 and it doesn't like slip on and off, but it's like, it's pretty snug.
It's cool too, yeah. Because the actual ring has these little nubs in it.
Nublins.
On the inside, I don't know if you can see that, but it has 3 nubs and those are what get your heart rate and everything. And so these are made exactly like the rings so you can try it on and make sure you really like that size.
Yeah.
So it's cool.
So I went with an 8 when my ring size is like a 5 3/4. So, not that that's gonna help anyone, but just get the ring kit. It doesn't cost any money or anything, and
there's no rush. You're spending a lot of money on it.
And then we
get good data.
Yeah, and then also we submitted them our sizes, and within like that day, I got a message being like, "Your aura ring has shipped." So, hopefully soon we can get our aura rings and.
I think it said to get this takes 2 days and then to get the ring takes 2 days. So it's always a 2-day turnaround.
Yeah. So yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, I've decided that I'm gonna work out today because I don't know if I'm gonna work out tomorrow, and then on Friday I'm definitely not working out. So I'm gonna do a P-Volv class. I haven't decided which one yet, but I know that it's gonna be less than 35 minutes because that's really all I have in me right now. So this is my outfit. It's from Lauren Jane, And let's go to the garage. Okay, I'm gonna do a 35 minute lower body sculpt Pevolve. So the gliders don't really glide on my floor, but we're just gonna do the best we can.
And burn. All we're using today is your Pevolve and your gliders. Let's get right into it.
I just finished my workout. I did the Pevolve, which you just saw, and then I walked for an hour. I cannot tell you how fucking difficult it is to get 10,000 steps. Like, I know I don't have my phone on me all the time, which is why I'm really excited to get the Aura ring, because
it does loop into health too.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm just excited because, yeah, I don't carry my phone around all the time, but like, I just walked at like a normal pace 3.0. for 30 minutes, and then I briskly walked at like 4. I don't know what it ended up being, but like maybe like 4.0 for another 30 minutes, and I'm only at 7,000 steps for the day. Like, I just don't understand how that's even possible. So to the people who get 10,000 steps, more fucking power to you, because it's rough out here. All right, I'm gonna show you guys my dinner. I'm gonna have a salad. It's literally just lettuce. I didn't put the dressing on yet. I think I'm gonna do like an Asian style dressing, right? Maybe? And then I have a buffalo tempeh sandwich, and then carrots, broccoli, and I think that's all I'm gonna have. And then I'll definitely have dessert, which is probably gonna be like some graham crackers, maybe a few marshmallows, and some chocolate. So that is it. I'm signing off for the day. You just came along with me for my entire day. And I will see you guys tomorrow. Bye.